puts it up. Michael Jordin for the tie. That is unbelievable. Dreams to come true. This is March Madness.
On a beautiful 82-degree day in Tulsa, Oklahoma, in his third-round action of the 2011 NCAA tournament. The winners advancing to the Sweet 16. Fans still making their way in for game one of our doubleheader here on TNT. It's the Arizona Wildcats, the fifth seed, facing the number four seed, the Texas Longhorns. The winner moves on to play the Blue Devils of Duke in the West Regional in Anaheim. Hi, everybody. I'm Marv Albert, along with Steve Kerr. We'll be joined momentarily by Craig Sager. Craig working the sidelines. Let's check out the starting lineups. And we open up with Arizona coming off the very tough win over Memphis here on Friday afternoon. Arizona getting off to that slow start. Big game for Lamont Momo Jones and the sophomore Derek Williams, the Pac-10 Player of the Year, came up very big. As for Texas, Steve, the major concern for Arizona is that big Longhorn front line with the Big 12 Freshman of the Year, Tristan Thompson, coming off a superb game in the win over Oakland on Friday.
He had seven blocks in that game, Marvin. I think that's the big matchup to watch here today. Texas's size in the front line versus Arizona, a smaller team, and Sean Miller very concerned about rebounding and giving up second chance opportunities to the Longhorns. So we'll see how that matchup unfolds.
And this high definition television broadcast for March Madness is provided by LG. Texas controlling the opening tip. Doz Bowboy. And this is Corey Joseph, Jordan Hamilton. Oh boy, whipping the pass down low. Tristan Thompson getting right to it. The other day, 17 points, 10 rebounds, career high 7 block shots.
And that's how Texas will attack Arizona. They're going to go inside, try to pound them in the paint. Momo Jones off on the jump shot.
Joseph coming across. Bowboy played by Jones. Bowboy found the opening. Derek Williams is up top. This is Solomon Hill with a series of moves. Nicely done. The sophomore from Los Angeles.
Solomon Hill going against Jordin Hamilton. Two players very familiar with each other, both having played in the Los Angeles area in high school.
Oh, there was contact. No foul. Gary Johnson saying why not.
Yeah, it looked like he got bumped, but a nice jump shot. He's a key guy for Texas. He's going to start on Derek Williams defensively. The Longhorns will bring multiple defenders at Williams, try to mix up the look on him all day.
Texas opening by hitting their first three shots. Williams trying to go baseline on Johnson. And the ball deflected out. And there's the head coach at Arizona, Sean Miller.
What a job he's done. Just his second season with Arizona, already has them in the NCAA tournament in the third round. And this was a rebuilding job after Dude Olson's retirement and a couple of subsequent interim coaches, Russ Pinnell and Kevin O'Neill. Derek Williams will go to the line, but a lot of people thought it would take Miller maybe 3 or 4 years to get things going. The key for him in this whole rebuilding process was getting Williams, Momo Jones, and Solomon Hill. All had committed to USC originally, but when Tim Floyd left the Trojan program, Sean Miller swooped in and got all three of these guys. Williams, obviously, the big one, a potential player of the year candidate.
Foul committed by Gary Johnson. Derek Williams spends much time at the foul line. The other day, 10 of 10 at the line. So Texas with a 6-3 lead. We're just underway with 2 minutes gone by. This is Joseph with some room. Yes, Corey Joseph out of Toronto, Ontario, Canada. He and Tristan Thompson knew each other back in the eighth grade. Ended up going to Finley Prep in Nevada together. And here they are on the same team. Back comes Balbe. Nice lead. Joseph could not hit the reverse. Williams met by Johnson.
Great transition defense from Texas. That's been a hallmark for them all year. Their offense is very efficient. As a result, they get back in defense often.
And that is a three-pointer. Kyle Fogg, who struggled the other day, he's back from a strained quad, able to knock down his first field goal attempt.
Very important shot for Fogg. He was out of rhythm the other day. Sean Miller telling us he had missed practice time with that injury. And even though the injury has healed, he didn't have his shooting stroke. And that first shot for Fogg, so important every game. He's a very streaky shooter.
Joseph coming off the cut, lost the handle. So Arizona in possession. They had a very difficult game again. Memphis only one for the first nine from the field. They were down 10-1 at the start. Nice second effort. Solomon Hill.
Now Arizona hanging in there. You see the length of Texas bothering both Williams and Hill. Anything easy they can get like that on those putbacks, huge boost for the Wildcats.
Hamilton trying to adjust the shot, and he did.
Boy, is he talented. I thought he was great the other day against Oakland. Hamilton has a tendency at times to get too shot happy from the perimeter. When he goes inside, he is really tough to stop.
There's Williams. Jordin Hamilton, 19 points, 10 rebounds, 3 assists in that game on Friday night. This game opening at a very fast pace. Johnson banks it off glass.
They've got multiple options in there. Johnson averages about 11 points per game. Thompson about 13. And Jordin Hamilton, 18. All of them, the ability to score down on the block.
And Steve, Texas has opened up by hitting 6 of their first 7 attempts. Nice footwork, but Preston Thompson was there for the block.
Yeah, there's that length. He did that against Oakland all game, and he will bother Derek Williams today.
Texas by 4. We'll be right back. We'd like to give a special welcome to all of our troops around the world watching the NCAA tournament on the American Forces Network. Texas up by 4 here in the early going. First time that these two schools have met in an NCAA tournament. And that is a three-pointer for Jordin Mayes off the bench. Played well the other night against Memphis. Hit a couple of shots, including a shot from downtown in his 14 minutes of play.
And you figure Arizona would shoot the ball better tonight. Just 5 of 19 as a team from the three-point line against Memphis, but they are just under 40% for the season.
And they're firing up threes. Texas, a team that at one point it appeared they had a shot to be ranked first in the nation, but they struggled down the stretch. Went 4-4 in the last 8 games coming into the tournament. They had won 11 in a row, 17 of the previous 18. They finished up second in the Big 12 to Kansas and then lost to the Jayhawks in the Big 12 tournament championship game. Horn called on that foul. Jamel Horn, who also checked in just a moment ago.
And you know, Marv, the big problem with that 4-4 stretch to finish the year is it really cost them the ability to go to San Antonio for the regional. Instead, Kansas gets the one seed in that region. But the Texas campus, about an hour away or less from San Antonio. Rick Barnes and his squad would have loved to have ended up there. And that swoon ends up costing them several seeds. And if they're capable of winning today, they'll end up in Anaheim instead of San Antonio.
And they had some big wins. Here's the alley-oop that has broken up. Texas defeating Kansas, North Carolina, Michigan State this season, all on the road or on neutral courts. Mayes gives it right back. Derek Williams. There's Williams off the dribble. Williams fires one up.
He has not really had a good look. Other than that three-pointer from the wing, everything inside has been challenged. Lexi Wanmany that time, and before it was Tristan Thompson. So many long bodies out there for Texas. They're going to give Arizona a lot of trouble, and Horn picks up his second foul.
Horn battling with Thompson down low. Tristan Thompson, Big 12 Freshman of the Year, who had one of his best performances of the season the other day. Horn with a quick two.
while Kirill Natyatsko comes in for Arizona. Sean Miller telling us he was going to give him plenty of minutes today because of his size. He's got the ability to match up with these bigger Texas players.
6 foot 11, 260. We might also see the 7-footer Alex Jacobson. A lot of big bodies on the floor and a timeout taken. So they maintain possession. Texas will hold on.
Welcome back to Tulsa. It's time for the Powerade Sideline Report. At the beginning of the telecast, Marv mentioned the size and the strength of the Texas front line, which Steve Kerr said could cause potential problems. To get ready and prepare for that, what did Arizona do? Well, they had their managers, that's Jerron Henry and Ben Tucker, swat away shots during practice with brooms. When your team managers are only 5'10", those props come in handy.
If you have to use props, you go to it. All right, thank you, Craig. Texas off to a good shooting start, 6 of 8 from the field. Arizona just 4 of 12, and I mentioned that bad start on Friday against Memphis, just 1 of 9. But Texas with just that 1 point lead.
I thought Arizona was a little tight against Memphis the other day. They look loose here today. I think they're fine. Emotionally, I think it's just an adjustment with this length of Texas. They're not a team that creates a lot off the dribble. And they play through Derek Williams, but they like to run a lot of motion, a lot of back screens, misdirection. They're going to have to be very crisp with their efficiency to get shots off against this great Texas defense.
Straightaway shot from Jacobin Brown, who had an excellent game the other night. Jordan Hamilton is back for Gary Johnson for Texas. Here is Mayes for three.
Wow.
Quick release. Jordin Mayes giving Arizona its first lead. That's his second from downtown.
Well, you mentioned, Marv, how well he played against Memphis. Had that huge three-point play late. Knocked down a couple free throws as well. And Mayes looking extremely confident out here.
Brown puts the spin on Fogg. Here's Brown. Lost control. And a good job by Jesse Perry getting the tie up on Alexi Wanmeni.
Well, when we talked to Sean Miller yesterday, he said we've got to fight for every loose ball and every rebound. Arizona, pretty good rebounding club, but Texas, one of the best rebounding teams in the country. And Miller was adamant about keeping Texas from those back-breaking put-back buckets that after Arizona has played a good defensive possession. So far, they've done a pretty good job of fighting them on the glass.
Possession arrow in favor of the Wildcats. Arizona in possession. Mayes moves it across. Being played now by Jay Lucas, who just checked in. Lucas got picked off. Wild shot attempted. And the foul is called. Jim Burr with the call, working with Richard Cartmell and Paul Jansen. Foul committed by Jacobin Brown. Every tournament game live online on your iPhone or iPad with NCAA March Madness on demand. For details, go to mmod.ncaa.com. Kevin Parham, a 75% free throw shooter, averages 8 points a game. He's out of the Bronx, a 6'6 sophomore. Texas down by 3. The winner here today goes to the Sweet 16. And Texas, after getting off to the good start, cooling off.
Jordan Hamilton on the miss. I think he's a really key guy for Texas today. He's the one guy in this Longhorn club who can create a shot from the perimeter. And if Arizona clamps down on the post, and I expect to see a lot of double teaming from them down there, Hamilton needs to make some plays.
Looks like Parham got shaken up after that air ball. 7-0 run by Arizona. Parham back on his feet. Wildcats with a three-point advantage.
Welcome back to Tulsa. Arizona with a three-point lead. Take a look at the last jump shot from Kevin Parham. Look at his left foot. It will land right on the left foot of Jacobin Brown, and boy, turns it pretty severely. And that's a potentially damaging blow for Arizona. We'll see if Parham is okay. Looks like he's going to the locker room, but he will be called upon to guard Jordin Hamilton much of the day. And he's also a critical part of this offense with his ability to handle the ball in transition and against pressure and to shoot threes.
Here's an open three for Lucas. So Texas has missed its last six shots. They opened up connecting on six of their first seven from the field.
Lamar, watching this team on tape, I think what stands out, if there's a weakness, it's their spacing offensively. They only have three legitimate three-point shooters, and you're going to expect Arizona to really pack it in the paint and make Texas make shots from outside.
Valbe. And this is a long three-point attempt. Jordin Hamilton firing from deep range. The foul is called on Tristan Thompson. And apparently Kevin Parham being retaped back near the locker room.
Yeah, it'll be very interesting to see what happens there, because he's a guy who has started the last several games before the tournament when Kyle Fogg was injured, and one of the Wildcats' better players the second part of the year, and a guy who creates offense for them. Remember, this is going to be a very tough game for Derek Williams inside, so Arizona needs all the playmakers they can get today.
Texas doing a good job to this point on Derek Williams. Here's Hill on a spin once again. Wow. Nice move by Solomon Hill.
He's such a key guy for this club for that reason. I mean, his ability at his size to put the ball on the floor and create plays. And to this point, it's been Solomon Hill and Jordin Mayes who have supplied the offense for Arizona.
6 points for Hill. Arizona's hit three from downtown, so despite their shaky shooting, they have a five-point lead. Hamilton lost the dribble. Shot clock down to seven. Lucas got the step, lost the handle. Here comes Williams, and he's fouled. Jordin Hamilton with the foul, hard foul. Derek Williams bounces right back up.
Well, here's the spin move from Solomon Hill. And again, the Wildcats are going to have to attack from the perimeter because of that Texas size. And here's the good, hard foul from Jordin Hamilton. Smart. You don't want to let a guy like Derek Williams get a dunk and get him going. He has not made a field goal yet, so a really smart foul. And Marv, at the other end, Arizona bringing that double team hard against Tristan Thompson. And I think we're going to see a lot of that the rest of the day. Force these Texas guards to make shots, and you see Rick Barnes going back to Corey Joseph, one of his better shooters.
And as Sean Miller told us yesterday, they would go hard with that double team on Tristan Thompson as long as they can. 11-0 run here by Arizona. They're up by seven. Just past the midway point of the first half. Marv Albert, Steve Kerr, Craig Sager. We're in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Once again, Arizona in possession. Jones, nice hesitation move. That's a rainbow attempted. Kept alive by Hill. Hill on the fade, try to go glass. Joseph, met by Jones. Thompson setting up down low. Now single coverage on Thompson. Tristan Thompson, back tap by Johnson. Jones diving for it, could not come up with it. It's still loose. Elmo Jones beating Texas down the floor, but blocked from behind by Thompson.
And both Williams and Hill stopped playing. They had an offensive rebound.
Back the other end, Jordin Hamilton.
That's just straight hustle from Valbe. Completely outworking the Arizona players. Both Williams and Hill were trailing the play. You've got to understand, Momo Jones is likely to get that shot blocked. And Texas with the hustle. Valbe, what a play.
That stops the 11-0 run for Arizona. Here's another steal. Two on one. Hamilton. The Longhorns within three. Timeout, Arizona.
Now this is a six-point swing. Hamilton with the block. The other end, it ends up in a dunk. And Arizona, all of a sudden, a little shaky.
Texas coming roaring back. Now within three, head coach Rick Barnes of the Longhorns out of Hickory, North Carolina, the one-time head coach at George Mason at Providence, Clemson, 13th year with Texas, the all-time winningest coach in Texas basketball history. Did bring Texas to a Final Four, a couple of Elite Eights, but there have been seven eliminations in the first or second round, including last year when they lost to Wake Forest. The steal by Joseph. Overthrew Hamilton, not able to save it.
Texas really picking up its defense here. Marvin, we're going to get another timeout, but Arizona has to do a better job of taking care of the ball.
Coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by Coke Zero, State Farm, and by Best Buy.
Greg Gumbel in New York with a Southwest Airlines tournament update for you. Over on CBS in Cleveland, Ohio State just destroying George Mason from long range. They've hit 11 of 18 from behind the three-point line. David Leidy is 7 for 7. It's a 67-42 Ohio State lead. Marv, Steve, and Craig, back to you.
All right, thank you very much, Greg. Winner here between Texas and Arizona. We'll move on to face Duke. Duke getting by Michigan this afternoon. We'll head to the West Regional at Anaheim. Consecutive turnovers for Arizona. Let's see what they can do here. Sean Miller making changes, going to his bench. This is Lavender. Horn. That was a three-point attempt.
Boy, this Texas defense is so good. Arizona just 6 for 21 from the field. They're having a hard time hitting open looks. They've stayed in the game with their three-point shooting and their offensive rebounding. They have 7 second chance points, and they forced some turnovers like that one.
Good job on the double. It's a 2-on-1. Nice setup.
Oh!
Mays blew the layup. Jacobin Brown on the run. A little flip to Thompson. Let's see what the call is here.
I think we've got a foul. Look at the missed layup from Mays. Texas, I'll tell you what, Marv, they're lucky to be within three right now. The couple turnovers from Arizona, we've seen the missed layup there. And there could have been an offensive putback on that fast break.
Apparently a held ball was called, so Texas maintains possession by virtue of the arrow. Brown and Balbe now working in the backcourt. Here is Thompson off the spin, way off.
He likes to go to that right shoulder. That's his move. But like most freshman big men, that post game is going to take some work.
And that is a three-pointer again for Jordin Mayes, his third of the day.
He can't make a layup, but he can make a long-range three. Jordin Mayes, wow.
43% on the season from beyond that three-point line. Kevin Parham is back on the floor for Arizona after hurting his ankle. Just under 6 left in this first half. Brown, and a foul is called.
Here's the Jordin Mayes three, and this is how Arizona is going to have to attack. Move the ball, move that Texas defense around, and make shots over the top or penetrate from the perimeter. Texas has proven that they will stop any post-up moves from Williams and Solomon Hill down low.
Derek Williams of Arizona called on the personal. Jordin Hamilton checks back in for Doge Balde. Gary Johnson handing to Corey Joseph. Johnson trying to set the pick. Johnson on a pick and roll and hits.
Beautiful execution on that pick and roll. Derek Williams way out on the perimeter on his hedge. And that allowed Williams, or that allowed Gary Johnson the space to find that jump shot.
Six apiece for Hamilton and Johnson. Johnson defending on Williams. Here is Lavender for three.
Arizona just lighting it up from the three-point line. What a contrast from the other day against Memphis. They couldn't buy one out there.
5 of 9 from downtown. Picked off by Derek Williams. Here comes Mayes. Kicks it out. Here's another three-point attempt. Lavender with his second from downtown.
And what a great play from Jordin Mayes. He had Lavender in his sights the entire possession. Here's the first one from Lavender, knocking it down. Then he gets a second one after Mayes finds him on a beautiful feed. Arizona, surprisingly up 10.
Steve, the Arizona bench on fire. They have outscored the Texas bench 16-0, and they've done it with a three-point shot. Thompson spinning, and he is fouled by Natsiasko.
And Rick Barnes telling his guys during the timeout, let's not forget the game plan. Go inside, guys, and that's what they did to try to stem this tide here a little bit. Go into Thompson. That's a huge advantage for Texas. They've got to do more of that.
The bench supplying 5 of the 6 three-pointers hit by the Wildcats. 6 of 10 from downtown. Here is Tristan Thompson, not a good free throw shooter, 49%, although he's been hitting his free throws in the tournament. Coming up on AT&T at the half, we'll get you all caught up on the latest tournament news, highlights, and updates, and the official announcement of the 4 Naismith Trophy finalists presented by AT&T. It's coming up at the half.
And Marshawn Miller really using his bench here. As Thompson misses that second free throw, he's shuttling players in and out. And I think part of the reason is he knows his defense has to scramble so hard after double teaming on the perimeter. He's asking for me, giving guys 2-3 minute shifts here.
Offensive foul against Arizona.
And if that's Williams, it's his second. Is that Williams or Natsiasko?
No, apparently Williams with number 2.
Yeah, that's a big foul, and that's been the problem for him this year. Foul trouble, particularly on cheap fouls away from the hoop. It's something he's got to get better at. Got to be smarter with that. And that's a major issue here. I would expect Sean Miller to keep him on the bench the last 4.5 minutes.
Slow start, 0 for 6, 3 points. And he'll sit. Thompson called for steps.
And Natsiasko's size is giving Thompson some problems. And Sean Miller told us that. He said he wanted to have Natsiasko on the floor, on Thompson in particular. And that time, Arizona did not even bring the double team.
Kirill Natsiasko out of the Ukraine. He's a 6'11", 265-pound sophomore like yourself. Speaks 4 languages. Russian, Lithuanian, Ukrainian, English. I give you credit for 1 out of the 4.
Exactly.
Hill with a series of moves, and he's blocked.
Got to move the ball on.
Gary Johnson, wild shot. Hill with the rebound, flying in for it. Here comes Hill. Trying to find Lamont Joe. Here he is, Momo, with the flip. Nice backdoor pass, and it's blocked. It's a goaltend. So the basket counts. Hill gets credit. Yes, it is springtime here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Arizona up 30-19. A look at our game summary. Arizona only 10 of 27 from the field, Steve, but 6 from downtown. How about Texas? They've hit 9 field goals, got off to the early start, but it's been a drought since then, and 9 turnovers.
Yeah, there's the number. I mean, and that's resulted in a lot of these Arizona three-point shots, because Texas's defense is so good in the half court, but everybody is vulnerable after a turnover, and that's what we've seen. Their offensive execution has been so poor that it's really hurt their defense.
Hamilton with the step, took a push from Hill. You look at Arizona, their two top scorers, Derrick Williams and Momo Jones, a combined 0-for-9. Yet, Sean Miller going to the bench. They've done it with the threes, and the bench has taken over for the Wildcats.
Well, this is a team that has seven players who have hit 25 or more three-pointers this year as Hamilton gets the mid-range jumper to go. So nobody other than Derrick Williams averages in double figures, but they have a whole group of guys kind of between that 5 and 9 point average. So multiple players are capable when they're stepping up tonight.
Just under three to go in the first half. Strong move, and it draws the foul. Once again, it's Solomon Hill, this time trying the right side of the baseline. Reminder, coverage of the Division I Women's Basketball Championship will continue Monday at 7 o'clock Eastern Time on ESPN2 and ESPN3.com with second round action. For more information on game times and matchups, go to NCAA.com.
Bob, I like what Arizona has done here offensively today. Sean Miller knows that the weak spot of the Texas defense is Jordin Hamilton. He can be good. He's very athletic. But his focus is really at the offensive end. But Miller has gone to Solomon Hill repeatedly in face-up situations against Jordin Hamilton, and Hill has responded. He's given Arizona a big boost.
Now Matt Hill, 6'10", senior, has come on for Texas. Solomon Hill, 10 points and 5 rebounds. Just being patient on this sequence. Thompson lost his footing, stepped out, lost his balance.
There's that double team again. Jesse Perry comes over to help Nyatsko, and watch, Thompson realizes at this point he's got nowhere to go. Nyatsko with good position, and a little sprain of the ankle for Thompson, and he's kind of holding it right now. We'll see if he's okay.
Came up hobbling. Tristan Thompson, who had an excellent freshman season, Big 12 Freshman of the Year, terrific game the other day, one of his best of the season, including the Texas NCAA tournament record of 7 block shots. See the turnovers, they average just under 12 for the season. They have already turned it over 10 times. Beautifully done as he finds Jordin Mayes.
Texas has extended its defense, trying to put pressure on Arizona. And the Wildcats with beautiful execution. They had him spread out on the back cut by the freshman Mayes.
Biggest lead of the game for Arizona. Mayes with 11 points and a foul call.
And this is what you do when you face pressure on the outside. Can you space the floor and create passing angles? And Jesse Perry with a beautiful find.
Foul on Mayes puts Gary Johnson at the line of 66%. Free throw shooter. Last season, Johnson, a reserve, playing in the shadows of Damian James, now a member of the Nets. Dexter Pittman, member of the Miami Heat.
Johnson was actually recruited heavily by Arizona. In fact, it came down to Texas in Arizona, and then assistant coach Josh Pastner, Houston native, thought he had Johnson. Pastner ends up going to Memphis, and Gary Johnson chose Texas. Has had a very successful career here.
Gary Johnson also first team academic All Big 12. That's another three. This time it is way off.
Maybe a little quick with that one if you're Perry. He can make a three now and then, but that's really not his shot.
Valbay for Hill. Just another 1.5 minutes remaining in this first half.
And Marv Jacoba Brown, really the only three-point shooter on the floor for Texas. So Arizona's guards have to do just that. Get in the paint and dig.
Once again, a forced shot by Thompson. And they've kept the ball away from Jacoba Brown. Arizona's done a good job against him. Yatsko with his first attempt. Here's Brown with a deep three.
Miller wants to hold it, although there's about a 15-second shot clock differential. And I think if you're Arizona, you really want to go back to Hill. He's the one guy on this team who's really creating offense right now. Get him lined up against Gary Johnson.
Mayes, Adyatsko. Shot clock to 10. Hill with it now, but out deep. Hill off the dribble, got the step. Here's Hill. Solomon Hill has had a sensational first half. That's 12 points, 36-23. Arizona final seconds of the half. Jacoban Brown off the dribble, and he is fouled. That'll put him at the line of 1-1.
Arizona extending a little bit too far defensively on that possession. Brown just missed that three. He didn't really want to pull up and shoot a three. And the Wildcats should have played him for that penetration. But meanwhile, Texas, where has their offense gone? 10 field goals, 10 turnovers.
Wow. And this after the good start. Texas not a good free throw shooting team, but Jacoban Brown is a very good foul shooter, 12 for 12 on Friday night.
And Marv, the amazing thing when you look at these turnovers, Texas was number one in the Big 12 in fewest turnovers per game. They averaged less than 12 per game, and they're almost at their season average already.
1.8 remaining in the half. Well, the Arizona bench outscoring the Texas bench 18-2. It was not the two high scorers who did it in the first half, Derek Williams and Momo Jones, very quiet, but they got help from elsewhere. They also were bombing away and hitting from downtown. A surprising first half, Arizona 36 and Texas 25. Let's go to Craig.
Well, Sean, I don't know what's more impressive, holding Texas to 25 points, forcing 10 turnovers, or the offensive end where your bench outscores them 18-2. You decide. What do you think?
Well, Craig, we probably don't get enough credit for having a bench that's contributed. It's one of the reasons that we're here today. We've played 10 guys for 36 games, and, you know, you get to this point, and I like to think they're comfortable, and, you know, to our team's credit, a lot of the guys, like you mentioned, came off the bench, did a great job, especially with Derek being out at the end.
All right, thanks a lot. Right now, it's Arizona leading at the half, and we will be back with AT&T at the half in just a moment.
Coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by Miller Lite, Buick, Fidelity Investments, and by Dove Men Plus Care.
Sellout crowd here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Better than 17,000 have turned out. In a surprise, Arizona leads it over Texas by 11 moments ago. Craig Sager talked to Texas head coach Rick Barnes.
Well, Coach, 10 turnovers and only one field goal by Tristan Thompson, who looks bothered by the double team. What adjustments do you have to make?
Well, one, we got to take care of the ball, but I do think we've got to do a better job on the defensive end. We just didn't get back to the three-point line. They obviously can shoot the ball. They're shooting 40%. But what Tris is going to have to do, he's going to have to fight for his space more. He was letting them get physical with him, get him off the block area. He's going to have to really fight and earn his space. But the biggest thing is we've got to play better defense as a team. And then on offense, we just simply have to execute and stay together.
All right, thanks a lot. Thank you, Mark.
Steve, a most unusual first half. The top scorers for Arizona not doing it. The bench turning things around.
Yeah, Solomon Hill and Jordin Mayes were spectacular. And meanwhile, the two leading scorers, Derek Williams and Momo Jones, a combined 0 for 9. So incredible turn of events for Arizona. But as we heard from Sean Miller going into halftime, he's got a lot of confidence in his bench, and they've come through big time.
This high-definition television broadcast from March Madness being provided by LG. Second half underway, Arizona in possession. They've done it with the three-point shot. They've hit 6 of 10 from downtown. The bench supplying 5 of those 6 3-pointers. And the foul is charged to Texas. Tristan Thompson with his second.
I think what Miller would love to do here is get Derek Williams a bucket early to try to get him involved in the game.
Williams blocked on that shot. Nice move by Corey Joseph going the distance. Corey Joseph out of Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Averaging 10 points, leads the team in assists. And you know that Texas would like to jump on Arizona here at the start of the second half.
They want to get back in it quickly with their pressure defense. And Solomon Hill takes it to the hole. And he has been the best player on the floor here today.
14 points, 6 of 9 shooting for Hill. This is Jordan Hamilton trying to back his way. Corey Joseph. Hamilton with a long three, yes.
And that's the guy who has to get going for Texas. That's a huge shot for him because he's a streaky three-point shooter. And if he can soften up this double team that Arizona's been throwing at the Texas bigs, then the Longhorns are in business.
First three-pointer for Texas. Hamilton just under 40% from downtown. A traveling violation as Derek Williams continues to have his problems.
Yeah, Tristan Thompson just has him all out of whack. The length that we talked about, we expected for Williams to be bothered at the rim, but it looks like right now he's even having his problems on the perimeter.
Arizona with an 8-point lead. Texas opened up by shooting the ball very well and then went through a long drought. Sean Miller going to his bench, and they certainly came through. Back to his starters. Now here's Hamilton again for three. Down to 5.
Now they've softened up the defense, and Hamilton coming out of that double team. We're going to see a quick timeout from Sean Miller. Texas spreading the floor off the double and finding the open Hamilton. The Longhorns back in it.
Look at our tournament summary. Congratulations to Mike Krzyzewski. 900th career victory. Duke defeating Michigan, and they will play the winner here. How about BYU? First Sweet 16 appearance since 1981. Jimmer Fredette has averaged 33 points over the first two tournament games, and a wild one between Butler and Pittsburgh yesterday.
Heartbreaking for Pitt, but let me just say this, Mark. The way the program handled it, from Jamie Dixon's comments to Nasir Robinson, who committed that last foul, the way he handled things in the media is just amazing. So mature, and just a heartbreaking loss for those guys.
Texas back to the offense. They are within 5. They've trailed by as many as 13. Here's Hamilton again.
I know he had made a couple, but it's a little quick. And I think if you're Texas, you've got to continue to play inside out, but you can get a better look than that if you're Jordan Hamilton.
Romo Jones continues to struggle with the shot. Johnson off the mark. And it is deflected out. Let's check in with Craig Sager. Craig.
Well, thanks, Mark. Congratulations to Duke and Coach Keenan's 900th win. We talked to Chris Collins, his top assistant, a few moments ago. He said the entire team is watching this game right now because they will play the winner. They have a 2.5-hour bus ride from Charlotte to the Durham campus. The coaches have a meeting tonight. The initial game plan will be given to the players tomorrow.
All right, Craig, Texas in possession after that ball was kicked out of bounds. 3 minutes in, second half. And the foul is called on Arizona.
Now you can see what's transpired here in the first few minutes. Texas has taken advantage of some long-range shooting from Hamilton. They've slowed the game down. And when they get Arizona in the half court defensively, the Wildcats are having a very difficult time scoring. So if you're a Texas fan, you got to hope this team continues to take care of the ball. Those turnovers really hurt their defense in the first half.
Mays picking up that last foul. Wilson gets it down low. Hamilton banking his way. Hamilton forks it. And a good job by Perry. Oh. to Solomon Hill. Derrick Williams trying to get it to Hill. Nice play. Saved by Jordan Hamilton. Valdez pass off the mark, but it's recovered by Gary Johnson. And they can regroup. Texas down by as many as 13 after they got off to the good start. They hit six of their first seven shots. Joseph gets the hop.
Yeah, the pace now completely in Texas's favor. They seem to have gotten control of this game. Arizona has to figure out a way to score a basket in the half court.
10-2 run, open up the second half. Derrick Williams. That's his first field goal. He had missed his previous six shots.
That's probably the way Arizona's going to have to attack with Williams. Not on a straight post up, but get him on the move. Allow him to use his quickness around that Texas defense.
Off the collision, Hamilton got the shot off. The save by Johnson ends up in the hands of Hill. Here's Fox, saw the opening. Mayes again. It's another three. And that is a career high for Jordin Mayes, 4 of 4 from downtown. He has 14 points.
And just like the first half, the turnover leads to the wide open shot in transition for Arizona.
And bodies continue to drop on the floor. Valbe just went down.
It was Williams' first hoop. And Sean Miller with the nice call, just trying to get him on the move on that pick and roll. And then Jordin Mayes picking up where he left off in the first half, knocking down that three. And Arizona extends that lead back to 8.
Greg Gumbel in New York with a tournament update for you. Over on TBS in Chicago, Southwest Regional play. Purdue with the early lead on VCU. Little Juwan Johnson bucket there. 10.5 minutes remaining. Purdue in the lead by 3. Back to Tulsa, Marv Albert and company.
Well, an intentional foul was just called on Jordan Hill of Arizona. And the man who took the hit, Doge Valbe, on the line for 2. And then Texas will have possession as we get another look.
Well, you saw on the left-hand side of your screen as Valbe misses 1 of 2. Take a look right over in this area here. Valbe sets the screen. Solomon Hill comes in, throws the forearm, and anything up in that face or neck area is an automatic intentional foul, which results in a couple free throws and the ball. So got to be careful if you're Hill. Remember the other day against Memphis, we saw Kevin Parham do the exact same thing. Sometimes this Arizona team can be a little young and immature.
Johnson, yes, and the foul.
I think it's Derrick Williams, which would be number 3. A tough call if you're Williams, but you see how he came down with the arms. If he had kept his hands straight up, he would have gotten away with that little bump. But he brought the hands down, and that caused the foul. And we'll see. I would expect Sean Miller to let him play through it now. You only got one game if you lose.
The Arizona lead is 5. Gone by second half. Horn's pass off the mark intended in the corner for Lavender.
It's the right idea against this defense with Williams struggling. You've got to put the ball on the floor from the perimeter and find open shooters. But a little miscommunication there between Lavender and Horn.
And now Jamel Horn takes a seat. Alexi Wanmeni has come on for Texas. Colin Brown, played by Lavender. Hamilton. Hamilton blocked. Hamilton on the recovery. Here comes Lavender. Lavender all the way. And a foul. Brendan Lavender tried to cut to his left and push it up, and he in turn was pushed by Brown.
Here's the look, and Brown just slides over enough to get a piece of Lavender, and that's why you see the foul called. And Marv, when we talked to Rick Barnes yesterday, we said, what happened to your team down the stretch when you went 4-4? And he said, well, we got a little impatient offensively. We started taking bad shots. And when we did that, it left us vulnerable at the other end. That's exactly what happened right there. And I think that's what he's telling Jordin Hamilton. That was a forced shot. And when you force it, it leaves your transition defense exposed.
Lavender, a 75% free throw shooter. Well, first they brought you real Coke taste and zero calories. Now they're bringing you the most impressive NCAA experience known to fans. Get in the game at CokeZeroSocialArena.com. The winner between Texas and Arizona will face the Blue Devils of Duke. Duke getting by Michigan this afternoon, and they'll meet in the West Regional out in Anaheim.
Boy, how about that finish? Michigan looked like they were dead in the water with about 6 minutes left. Incredible comeback, and almost tied it on that last second shot.
Hamilton way off. And a reaching foul.
I believe it was Nutyasko. He and Wanmany were fighting for position. And Tristan Thompson will come back in the game. There's the bracket. Duke seems like they're in the Sweet 16 every season.
Kirill Nutyasko, who did a nice job in the first half defensively, back on the floor, picked up a second foul. Again, he is defending on Tristan Thompson. Thompson is up high. Well, not able to get going. Kicks to the rim and a foul.
Before the shot, Jim Burr making the call. Nice little hesitation move from Brown coming off that dribble handoff.
It's number three, committed by Mays. So it is a non-shooting foul. Rick Barnes likes to see Brown take to the rim. He wants him going to the line. He's an excellent free throw shooter, as we saw Friday night here in Tulsa. Wanmany, Brown. Here's the double on Thompson. Brown with the spin, lost it, but it's recovered. Alexi Wanmany, a junior from Cameroon.
Pretty interesting story. Wanmany, the adopted son of Spurs GM R.C. Buford. He met him in a Basketball Without Borders camp sponsored by the NBA in Africa. Wanmany ended up moving to San Antonio, going to high school for a year there, and ended up at Texas Longhorn.
Off the move by Jesse Perry. Foul on Thompson. That's his third. Well, Virginia Commonwealth and Purdue playing right now in Chicago. And that game is being seen over on TBS. Spiro Dedis, Bob Wenzel have the call. Perry spinning his way. Banks it home.
Wow, nice move over the top of Gary Johnson. And any hoop Arizona can get right now in the half court, particularly with Derek Williams on the bench, almost gravy.
First field goal for Perry, a junior out of St. Louis, Missouri, junior college transfer. Coming up on 12 minutes remaining in the second half. A Texas turnover leads to a 3-on-1. Perry, once again.
Turnovers again, Mark. Turnovers, it's been the story. Every time Texas takes care of the ball for a few minutes and makes it a half-court game, they come back, but then they continue to turn it over and allow Arizona to extend that lead again.
Wildcats up by 9. Hamilton trying to feel the contact, looking for a call. Mays with the lead pass as Nagatsko lands in the crowd.
If that's LeBron James, that's maybe a good foul, but a good pass, but not Kirill and not Yatsko.
Well, here come the Jayhawks of Kansas as they get ready to meet up with the Fighting Illini in our second game.
Welcome back to Tulsa. Right now, Arizona leads by 9. If you would like to make a donation to support the relief effort following the recent earthquake and tsunami disasters in Japan, log on to cnn.com/impact. Jordin Hamilton's brother Gary is a professional basketball player in Japan. I talked to his mother Karen Thursday. She said that season has been canceled due to the disasters. However, Gary is remaining in Japan. He is volunteering his time and services as part of the recovery effort. Mark?
We send our best to to Gary and the Hamilton family. Jordin has come on in the second half. He now has 14 points in all. Texas opened up second half with a 10-2 run.
Brown.
So he will now head to the line. Coven Brown, who spent a lot of time at the line on Friday night in the game against Oakland. Here's a programming reminder. Wild and Nocturnal. Catch Conan in his natural habitat on TBS. All new Conan weeknights at 11, 10 Central. Only on TBS.
Marv, Arizona's coming out so hard on those hedges on the high pick and rolls that it's leaving them a little bit exposed inside. And I think it's the way Arizona plays pick and roll constantly. I think Sean Miller wants consistency, so he teaches it that way. But with these Texas guards, they're not great shooters off the pick and roll. They don't have great range. If I were Arizona, I'd consider going under those screens, making them shoot over the top.
Tristan Thompson has checked back in. He's playing with three fouls. Here's pressure being shown now by the Longhorns. Momo Jones handling. Arizona up by seven. At the 11-point lead at the half. Nice twisting move by Derek Williams to draw the foul.
Now you see the adjustment. Now, because of the struggles for Williams, as you look at the shot chart, his one basket was a dunk on that pick and roll. 1 for 7, 5 points. So much trouble with his length. And you saw the adjustment on that play, too, getting him on the move with that pick and roll. So Sean Miller really doing a nice job of trying to find another way for Derek Williams to score.
Foul is committed by Johnson. What a game for Derek Williams in the win over Memphis here on Friday. 22 points, 9 of 9 at the line, 10 rebounds. Have that key block on Wesley Witherspoon with 2 seconds left. Hit a key three-point shot. That has a shot at breaking your school record. You shot 57% on three-pointers for Arizona's Final Four team in 1988. Took 199 shots. Hamilton. That's a three. He has 17, and it's a six-point game. But head coach Sean Miller said if it were in the gym and you and Derek were shooting the threes, he'd put his money on you.
Well, the amazing thing about Williams, 60% from three, as you said, is how far gets the jumper to go. But over 300 free throws also, which leads the country. Very rarely do you see a guy who gets to the line so often. Also, he's such a great three-point shooter. Just an incredibly versatile offensive talent.
Johnson working inside. Able to find the space. Solid game again for Gary Johnson. He has 12 points.
Now, Texas has just so much strength down there on the block. And when they get penetration for Jacobin Brown and Corey Joseph, plenty of drop-off options between Thompson and Johnson.
Off the steal, here's Brown. Brown to the reverse. Fogg did not want to foul him. Try to cut him off from the angle to bother the shot.
And we get back to that slower pace that Texas prefers. They're able to squeeze Arizona down in the half court.
It is down to a 4-point lead. Williams off the spin. He lost his footing. He's shaken up, but he drew the foul.
And if that's Gary Johnson, I believe that's number three. And Jacobin Brown, the tightrope on the sideline. I think a good no call, though. Looked like he managed to keep his feet. Take another look. Took about 3 steps where he was right there, but look at the official right on it.
Trying to go wide and then ended up with the reverse. And the foul is called on Brown.
Okay.
So that is number three on Brown. For instant analysis and highlights of every tournament game, log on to SI.com. And Derek Williams, a 75% free throw shooter, has missed two here today. He's 5 of 7 at the line. He averages 19 points, 8 rebounds. Might have drawn some blood, yes, right elbow, so they will check that out. Derek Williams, the Pac-10 Player of the Year. last season Pac-10 Freshman of the Year.
Sean Miller coming back with Perry and Parham. He continues these mass substitutions throughout. And here you see on the spin move, Brown gets that hand in there and then the elbow hits the ground. I think that's where he scraped it up. But Rick Barnes, on the other hand, sticking with this five. This has been his best lineup today. Brown and Joseph in the backcourt with Hamilton, and that gives him his three outside shooters. And I don't know how much more of Balbe and Jay Lucas we'll see, because with this lineup, it extends that Arizona defense. It makes it much more difficult to cover.
Sean Miller looking to get a sub in, and Karel Nagatsko being waved on.
And Brendan Lavender now will shoot the free throw, and this is a rule that's allowed here. Because of the blood, Sean Miller gets to pick who he wants to shoot the free throw while Williams is being attended to, and then he gets to come back in.
Lavender, 75% free throw shooter.
And he had made two as well just a few minutes ago.
Once again, Brown on the drive. And again, he draws the foul. This is what Rick Barnes wants to see. He's very happy with Brown constantly going to the rim the other night, because it put him at the line 12 times and he hit all 12 free throws. Lavender picked up that foul.
And I think Barnes has made a nice adjustment himself here after all that double teaming in the first half when Texas was going directly into the post. He's gone away from that. The double team was such a problem. He's gone away from it. Now he's trying to get dribble handoffs on the perimeter, find those gaps. And I think if you're the Texas front line, now you've got chances for rebound opportunities, offensive boards, and the penetration of Brown has become a problem for Arizona.
Kyle Fogg returns for Brendan Lavender. The Arizona lineup. Points for Brown. He's done most of his damage at the line. The Texas contingent in this crowd on its feet. The Longhorns have come within two. Oh, strong move.
How about the inside reverse pivot that allows him that momentum to get himself going to the hoop so quick? Derek Williams.
Jump out at Joseph. Brown with the step. And again, he's hit.
Brown is willing his club back into this game. The penetration is just killing Arizona right now. But at the other end of the floor, look at this quick first step. Derek Williams exploding to the hoop. And again, instead of posting up, he's facing up. He's on the move. He's using his quickness. And he's finally finding some rhythm out here.
They're on the 1-1. Jacobin Brown is now 7-for-7 at the line, 83% free throw shooter. And he has brought them back. Arizona by two. Kevin Parham.
How many big shots have these Arizona bench players hit tonight?
And he's a good shooter. Overall, he's at 51%. 58-53 Arizona. Almost Jones met by Coven Brown. This is Perry. Perry sets the pick. The ball in the hands of Derek Williams.
Look how spread the floor is for Arizona. Sean Miller really trying to stretch out this Texas defense to give the players some driving lanes. But good defense by Jacobin Brown.
With three on the shot clock, Jones try to fire it up. There's Brown, rejected. And it's Johnson. with the follow.
And there's that offensive rebound we talked about. Penetration leads to good things. You don't have to make a shot. When you have a front line like Texas's with all that size, just get the ball somewhere near the hoop. And with Arizona trying to block a shot, they're out of rebounding position. Great game, Arizona by three.
Greg Dumbel in New York with a tournament update for you. A couple of games to tell you about over on TBS in Chicago. VCU going into the locker room with a 10-point lead at halftime, while on True TV, Syracuse with the early lead on the Marquette Warriors in a matchup of Big East teams. We'll keep you updated. Back to Tulsa, Marv Albert, Steve Kerr, Craig Sigler.
All right, thank you, Greg. Arizona in possession, clinging to a 3-point lead. They've led by as many as 13. 7 minutes to play in the second half. Trying to get Derek Williams going. Solomon Hill off the double. Beautiful pass to Williams. And the foul.
How about that pass? It's like a reverse finger roll. I don't know how he saw Williams. Take a look at this. Solomon Hill has done this all night, but look at that vision. And Longmany on the foul. Wow, what an amazing pass by Solomon Hill. He has been fantastic here today.
So Williams showing signs coming on. That's his 12th point, 9 have come in the second half. And the Wildcats of Arizona up by 6. Winner of this game will beat Duke in Anaheim at a West Regional. Colvin Brown, 12 points for Brown.
He's not shot the ball well, but he's really picked it up here in the second half with his penetration, his free throws. Now he gets a jumper to go. Texas really running its entire offense through Colvin Brown.
Jordin Mayes back on the floor, had the hot hand early. And he stepped out. Jesse Perry backed up, stepped out of bounds.
See, so many players do that on that baseline pass because they want to catch the ball and then move, and then they step back. And good call by Jim Burr, all over it. That's something you actually have to practice. You have to practice catching the ball from that angle and keeping your feet down before you penetrate.
Thompson setting the pick. Here's Hamilton at a foul. Jordan Hamilton taking to the rim. He's a 78% free throw shooter. Both teams are over the limit. The foul is called on Hill. That is his third. A reminder, the NBA returns to TNT for a special Tuesday doubleheader. Chicago Bulls at the Atlanta Hawks starting at 8 o'clock Eastern time, and then the Phoenix Suns and the Los Angeles Lakers in LA.
John Miller goes back to his bench. We've seen this all game. Texas has not really changed much in its lineup other than Wanmany coming in here for a few minutes. So are the Longhorn guards going to show any fatigue? Joseph and Colvin Brown have been out here most of the second half.
Nice pass. Derek Williams with the setup. Beautiful give and go. 16 points for Mayes, just adding to his career high.
They just spread out the Texas defense and attacked from the perimeter with their spacing and their cutting. Done a pretty nice job since those early troubles.
Brown on a spin. Wow. Colvin Brown, who was the story for Texas down the stretch Friday night against a very tough Oakland team out of Rochester, Michigan. That was a 4-point victory for the Longhorns. Hill gets inside. Hits high off glass.
He's been spectacular. This is one of the best games he's played in his entire career. And Arizona has taken advantage of that matchup. Jordan Hamilton having a lot of trouble staying in front of Hill.
Solomon Hill has 16 points, shooting 7 of 11. Offensive foul.
Boy, it's been feast or famine with Jordan Hamilton. We saw him hit those three threes early in the half to bring his team back. But we've also seen some quick shots and now a turnover on that offensive foul. Hamilton kind of all over the map here.
Foul number 3 on Jordan Hamilton. Arizona back in possession. Arizona during the season lost in the Pac-10 tournament championship game to the University of Washington in overtime of that game winner by Isaiah Thomas. Overall, they're 28-7. They've won 15 of the previous 18 coming into the NCAA tournament and won the opener, just getting by Memphis in a tough game, 79-77. Here's another three-point attempt. Janelle Horn coming up short. It counts, and the foul, Jacobin Brown again.
Where would Texas be, Marv, without Jacobin Brown? I mean, he's been the entire offense here in the second half. His penetration, his aggressiveness, he's kept his team in the game, both with his play and with his confidence. And look at the bench loving it. And now Brown, a chance to tie the game. It's been a long time since they've been even.
16 points, 14 in the second half. Foul committed by Lavender. And Brown continues to spend much time at the line. He is 9 for 9. Again, perfection. Hit all 12 of his free throws the other night. 2-point Arizona lead. Coming up on 4 minutes to go. Nice pass inside and a foul. That'll put Derek Williams at the line.
Good execution offensively from Arizona. And again, bringing Williams off a series of picks. Remember early in the game, they were trying that straight post up to him, and he had so much trouble with the length. And they've done a great job of getting him on the move here in the second half, and he's finally found his groove.
6 of 8 at the line. Foul is on Gary Johnson. That is his fourth, but he has been inconsistent with the shot at the line. It's been all over the rim.
Mm-hmm.
The Texas front line with foul difficulties. 4 on Johnson. Thompson has 3. Thompson with the rebound as Williams uncharacteristically misses on both. Texas can tie or take the lead. Here's Brown. Thompson missed the follow.
Jacobin Brown begging the official for a call. Arizona finally doing a better job of staying in front of him on that penetration.
Just under 4 minutes. Remaining second half. Mo Jones.
I think you got to go back to Solomon Hill with that Jordan Hamilton matchup. He's had so much success.
Shot clock to 4. Williams forcing. Not made contact with the rim. Shot clock violation.
He may get that call in the NBA whenever that happens, but that's not a call you get at the collegiate level.
All right, Steve, let's take a look at the Coke Zero impressive moment.
Yeah, Solomon Hill trying to get on the One Shining Moment video in a couple of weeks. In the first week of this tournament, that may be the best pass we've seen, finding his teammate Derek Williams somehow behind him. Williams finishing it and drawing the foul.
Arizona trying to hold on to this 65-63 lead. They've led by as many as 13.
And this was the play just before the timeout. Derek Williams going with that up and under move. And Texas fans are pretty familiar with that move if they've watched Kevin Durant since his Texas days, now with Oklahoma City. A lot of guys in the NBA do that, but Durant really proficient with it. Williams not getting the call.
Texas has come roaring back, led by the man with the basketball, Jacobin Brown, who wants to go back to the line and does. 12 for 12 at the line on Friday night against Oakland, and he's hit all 9 of his free throws here this evening. The foul is on Kirill Natyatsko. A programming reminder, they're turning the courtroom upside down. This much fun should be illegal. Franklin and Bash premiere this June only on TNT.
Tell you what, Jacobin Brown got away with one there. He's been penetrating at will, but Natyatsko that time did a great job staying in front of him, kept his arms high. If anything, that was an offensive foul. But look at him living at the free throw line throughout this weekend. Amazing shooting numbers.
83% at the line coming into the tournament. The game is tied at 65, and you can hear it from the Texas portion of this crowd.
Rick Barnes, I assume, will give Brown a very brief rest because I don't know where else they're going to go offensively at this point.
Brown 19 points, 17 coming in the second half. We're down to 3 minutes to play. The winner advances to face the Blue Devils of Duke at the West Regional out in Anaheim, California on Thursday. Mayes has had the hot hand. Derrick Williams. And we get a whistle down low. Jim Burr making the call against Texas. It's number 4 on Tristan Thompson.
It's also free throws now for Arizona. And you see the push. Williams selling it a little bit. That is the 10th foul, so it's the double bonus for the Wildcats. Williams just missed 2. So we'll see if he can find that rhythm again. Just 6 for 10 on the line, or on the night, from the free throw line for Williams.
Both teams now in the double bonus. I mentioned earlier, he spends much time at the line, leads the nation in free throw attempts, and usually hits the foul shots.
He has his moments, though, where he loses his groove. He's had a few games like this year. Wildcat fans can't believe it. They're used to seeing him knock down the big ones.
Derrick Williams connects on 1 of 2, and it's a 1-point Arizona lead.
Brown right back in the game, handling the ball.
Third round action in the 2011 NCAA tournament. 2.5 remaining second half. Johnson sets the pick and a foul. Brown headed right back to the line, hit by Jesse Perry.
And I don't understand why Arizona is extending on these hedges 30 feet from the hoop. Brown is not really a great three-point shooter. He hasn't made one here tonight, but he's living at the foul line. That's the last thing you can do, is bump him out there. Go under the pick, make him make an outside shot.
He's 11 for 11. Jordan Hamilton checking back in. Alexi Wanpenny also back on the floor.
Some offense, defense substitutions for Rick Barnes. Right now, Wanpenny, a terrific defender. And I would look for him to be matched up with Derrick Williams here on this possession.
For Texas, their first lead since the early moments. They were up 12-11, about 4.5 minutes into the game. They've come back from a 13-point deficit. We're down to 2 minutes, 20 seconds to play. Williams with the step. Williams on the follow. Williams again. Block. Williams again. Foul.
The double effort, the triple effort. Williams showing his quickness off the ground. The first step to get past Wanpenny, then the long arms to get multiple looks. And finally on the last one, he gets fouled by Joseph going up.
Let's see what Williams can do now at the line. He's 7 of 12, but has struggled as of late. Game is tied at 67.
Well, offense, defense again. Brown back in the game. You know where Texas is going. Let's see if Arizona makes an adjustment. Do they go under the pick? Do they try to keep him out of the paint, or do they continue to go with that high hedge? Got to be careful. He's going to run right into that pick.
Once again, Williams 1 of 2 at the line. Tristan Thompson has also made his return for Texas. Tied at 67. Brown, way off. Question is, was it deflected? The call is yes, it was.
It was, but you did see the adjustment from Arizona. No hedge by the big, forcing Jacobin Brown to shoot that jumper. Nice adjustment by the Wildcats, although it might have been better to do that about 10 minutes ago.
Brown will look to inbound. Hamilton. Hamilton with a jumper. And Arizona in possession. Omo Jones. Move it across. Met by Corey Joseph. Jones takes the timeout. It has come down to this, a minute 37. Remaining second half, Arizona and Texas tied at 67. Look at the game summary. Field goal percentage about the same now, but Arizona has hit eight from beyond the three-point line. And the story for Arizona, the freshman out of Los Angeles, Jordin Mayes, with a career-high game.
He's been terrific. With Momo Jones struggling, he's been the guy to pick up the slack offensively. Now, if you're Arizona, where do you go? You got to think it's going to be Derek Williams.
Mays leading the way with 16. He's hit four from downtown. That's a travel. A traveling violation to give the ball back to Texas.
Now, this is a young Arizona team. They play a lot of freshmen and sophomores, and they've had some trouble closing out games this year. Turnovers have been an issue, mental mistakes. And Solomon Hill just picks up that pivot foot. Critical play.
Timeout is called by Texas. They have two left, Arizona with one timeout remaining. Look at the game reset. Possession arrow pointing toward the Longhorns. Texas two timeouts, Arizona with one, and both teams in the double bonus.
Yeah, Tristan Thompson comes back out onto the floor. Has had a tough night, just one field goal, foul issues. The Arizona double team early on really bothered him. Can he find something in the lane right now? You got to think Jacobin Brown will be on the penetration, maybe find Thompson on a drop off or an offensive putback for Thompson.
Thompson with four fouls. The other big man, Johnson, has four. Brown has to come up on a minute remaining. Game tied at 67. Here's Brown on a crossover. Brown, yes! Texas with a 69-67 lead.
Good position from Kyle Fogg, but once again, the strength of Jacobin Brown getting into the lane and shooting over the top of the Arizona defense.
Down to 50 seconds remaining. Jones, who has been very quiet. Williams, here's Hill. Hill on the move with the spin. Hill's shot was blocked, kept alive. Williams for three. Kept alive by Hill, tries to split through and a foul.
I think they're going to give Arizona a timeout first. Jim Burr is signaling for a timeout, and I think it preceded the foul call from the other official.
The Texas bench very upset, but they get the timeout.
What a block by Thompson, showing that length and athleticism. Texas trying to hang on.
Arizona just used its final timeout. Texas has two left, and both teams in the double bonus.
And that timeout is a major issue here, because if Arizona can tie it up here and Texas scores at the other end, there's nothing the Wildcats can do. They've got to just push the ball and get a shot.
Out of 20 seconds, Williams going behind the back. Williams spinning his way, forced it. Texas calls for time. Jordin Hamilton in possession. They doubled up on Derek Williams. Try to force the shot. An excellent job defensively by the Longhorn.
Great job defensively. Sean Miller wanted the foul, but I thought it was good defense. Hamilton staying down on the floor.
See timeouts remaining. Arizona without any. Texas has one left. Texas up by two.
And here's, let's take a look. It was Tristan Thompson who stayed down. You know, if, on that second look, he did come down with that left arm a little bit. And if you're Sean Miller, it's understandable that you're upset, particularly with some of the calls Jacobin Brown's been getting at the other end. But doesn't matter. No call. Now if you're Arizona, keep the ball out of Brown's hands.
14 seconds remaining. Second half, Corey Joseph has to use the final timeout. Overs are not in time. 5-second violation.
Wow.
So Arizona
will get the basketball. Joseph thought he had just a little bit more time.
And a great job by Williams. Derek Williams coming over and denying Brown. And as you mentioned, no timeouts for Arizona. So where did they go?
Hill will throw in. Out of 10, Fox gets it down low. Williams. Oh!
What a pass from Kyle Fogg. The pick and roll, Williams, and the little drop pass. Texas can't get position, and somehow Williams gets it to go. Watch Hamilton on the rotation, just a step late, not in position. Good call, and Williams with a chance to give his team the lead. What a turn of events.
Foul was called on Hamilton, and apparently now they are going, we're told, over to the scorer's table.
They may be looking at the clock, Mark, to see if they have the right clock situation. I'm not sure what else they could be looking at. They can't go back and check on that five-second call. I don't think that's reviewable. So I believe, you know, in these situations, remember Jim Burr was in that situation in the Big East in the final seconds where the few seconds were not accounted for. So you got to feel like he's maybe overly sensitive to making sure they get the clock right. I think that's the issue here.
I think you're right. Extra attentive to the clock, but it provides a moment to gather for both teams.
Yeah.
Because both are out of timeouts.
They're going to keep it at 9.6. And meanwhile, Derek Williams just had to think about that free throw for an extra 45 seconds. And if you're him, you would have much preferred just to go right to the line coming off the emotion of that shot and that play.
So they made a minor adjustment, 9.6 the matter. He's 8 of 14 at the line, 3 for his last 8. Arizona by 1, no timeouts for Texas. It has come down to this. Jacobin Brown, down to 3, down to 2. Brown fires it off, comes up, it's over. Texas looking for a foul. They will not get the call.
Marv, the three officials conferred at the end. They looked at each other. They said, did you call a foul? They all said no, and they left the floor. And Texas, devastated.
Arizona advances to the Sweet 16. They will take on the Blue Devils of Duke in the West Regional at Anaheim. For Arizona, the sixth time in 11 seasons that they make it to the Sweet 16. The last time Arizona played in Anaheim was the 2003 West Regional. And Sean Miller and his Wildcats pull it out in a thriller here in Tulsa.
Well, so much going on that last play. Jacobin Brown driving, wanted contact. Watch here, Fogg does a nice job staying in front of him. Didn't look like there was a foul here. This is the one that Texas wanted, right there. On the follow, take a look. Was it Gary Johnson on the offensive board, or was it Jordin Hamilton? I think it was Johnson, yep. And now right here, does Arizona foul him? No time left. That may have been the issue. And so many issues for the officials to deal with. Was it a foul first? And secondly, would it have been in time? And what a devastating loss after Texas battled their way back.
Texas failing to reach a Sweet 16 four times the last 5 years. Derek Williams did not have one of his stronger games, but hit the big bucket down the stretch. 14 of the 17 in the second half. Let's go to Craig Sager. Craig.
Well, first of all, congratulations. Your All-American Derek Williams had been struggling all night, but you set up apparently the winning play. Take us through those final seconds.
You know, when you have a great, great player, the thing that you're going to, when you get on the plane at the end of the game, after the game, you're going to feel a lot better if he had the ball, make or miss. And I give him tremendous credit because I'm here to tell you, he hasn't struggled like that offensively one time this year. And there was no head hanging. There was no, not tonight's my night. At the very, very clutch moment after playing, in his mind, probably subpar, he finished the game off. He's like Mariano Rivera of the Yankees. When the game's on the line, he finishes the other team off. And can't say enough about this guy right here.
Well, you closed out both games. A sensational block in the first round. Here with a three-point play. Coach mentioned you struggled. How did you keep your head mentally?
You know what? They have big guys on the other team. And, you know, coaches like, you might struggle. You know, they have long arms. So just keep your head in it. Don't get frustrated. And I didn't get frustrated tonight. And I'm glad we got the win.
Going to the Sweet 16, and as we say now, it's win and you get to go home. Congratulations.
Exactly. I'm just waiting to get home and see all my family and friends.
Well, thanks a lot. Thank you, Lar.
Thank you, Craig. Derek Williams, the Pac-10 Player of the Year, with the three-point play with 9.6 to go to put Arizona in the lead. And you see the bracket for Thursday in Anaheim. It will be Duke and Arizona.
Very favorable geographical location for Arizona. Pac-10 country. So many of the players on this roster from the Southern California area. And if you're Arizona, just to get this far, what a breakthrough for this program. You know, nobody could have expected Sean Miller to turn things around this quickly. Just an amazing job.
And the last time Duke and Arizona met, NCAA 2001 championship game, Duke beat Arizona at the Metrodome in Minneapolis. Again, the final score, Arizona 70, Texas 69. Marv Albert, Steve Kerr, Craig Sager saying so long for now from Tulsa. Reminder, third round March Madness continues live right now on True TV and TBS. Back to our studio and the road to the Final Four after this.